Hello guys and welcome back. In this lecture, we're going to be learning how to create this design in Adobe Illustrator, okay? And we're going to learn one new tool, which is the Shape Builder tool, which will aid us in creating this design. So just come on Adobe Illustrator, create your new file and import your reference file, which we did the last time. All you need to do is come to File, and then Place, and come to Project Files and select this one which says your first drawings in Illustrator reference image tool. So select it and click on template and then place. So it's going to place it just like we have it here. Okay, now the first thing to do is of course to come to direct angle tool and create your rectangle like this, or your square. Okay, so now, how does the Shape Builder tool work? Okay, so let me just demonstrate how the Shape Builder tool works. So let's assume we have two shapes, or let's say three shapes like this. And we have them with different colors. Let's give this guy no stroke. No stroke, and make this one green. Then let's see, no stroke and make it orange. This guy no stroke. Let's see, we want it to be black. Okay, great. Now this is the Shape Builder tool. The one we see here. Okay, now this is the Shape Builder tool, and when you select the tool, first of all you have to select the shapes you want to use the tool on, and then select the tool. Now what the tool does is it creates shapes based on the arrangements of shapes we have on our workspace. Okay, so when we select the shapes and select the tool, we can just click on one shape and add it to another shape. Now you see the both shapes are the same, so I'm just going to undo, and so also like this. You see now the shapes are now the same. You can just drag it around all of them. Now you see all of them are now the same shapes. Okay, so what you can also do with the Shape Builder tool is you can minus shapes from each other. Okay, so when you hold down Alt and then click here, you see that it has minused this intersection. Okay, just going to undo and then just hold down Alt. Okay, when I hold down Alt, instead of this plus icon, it's going to show the minus icon, which signifies subtraction. Okay, the plus signifies addition, which means it's going to add shapes together, while the minus shows subtraction, which means it's going to subtract shapes from each other. So when I hold Alt and drag the shapes like this, we can see that it has subtracted this whole shape from the one we have here. And one other thing we can do with the Shape Builder tool is to add colors. Okay, so let's assume we have this color. Let's assume we choose the color here. We can use the Shape Builder tool to add the color. Okay, give display the color, and just based on the colors we want, we can choose a color. And okay, yeah, so basically this is one of the one of the uses of the Shape Builder tool, apart from creating shapes based on intersections and based on the arrangement of the shapes, of different shapes which we have, it can also be used to kind of add colors to specific points. Okay, so just delete this demonstration we have here and come on your ellipse tool and kind of create your ellipse. Let's make it this big. Okay, and then I think we have to make it bigger, a bit bigger. Yeah, now let's give it a stroke color. Let's swap the color and make it a stroke color, and just Control C and Control F and reduce the size like this, while holding down Alt and Shift, reduce the size like this. Okay. And then let's just Control C and Control F again. And just let's just make this one smaller. Okay. We're going to increase the size later on, but let's work with this first. So the first thing you want to do is select this and swap back the color and give it, let's see, a blue color, and select this guy and swap back the colors to. Okay, so the first thing you can do is just select both of them. Okay, select both of them and select your shape builder tool, and holding down Alt, click here. Now we have a cut in the middle here. Now, and the same thing you can do here. So select this one, give it the fill color back, and select the other shape and select your shape builder tool, holding down Alt, you can minus this shape from the entire shape. Now, as you can see, we now have two different shapes, okay? And of course, we want more cuts at this point, right? So just select the both of them, come to File, come to Windows and Pathfinder, and let's just divide. Okay, so when we divide, we then have our separate shapes like this. Okay, now just kind of swap the colors so as to see what's going on under. And for this other one, all we then need to do right now is just make it bigger, as big as this, and then just send it to the back. Right click and arrange send to back. Okay, so it appears beneath all these other shapes. Now this one, we need to give it a purple. Okay, let's just undo them for now. Sorry, ungroup them for now, and then give this guy an orange color. Okay, give it an orange color, give this guy a purple color, and then give this guy a yellow color. Let's choose this sheet of yellow. So all you then need to do is to select all of them. I'm sorry, just select each of them and swap back the colors. Good. And now when we disable our template layer, we then see our awesomeness. Enable it back, and we can just do the same thing for this other part. Okay, so you can actually create them from scratch. I recommend we do so, and we can also actually just kind of group them together and then just duplicate them like this, and then just rotate them like this and fit them together like this, and fit them perfectly. And that instead of redoing everything, and I feel we should just make do with this. So once more, you can just swap the colors. Let's ungroup you. We just swap all the colors just to see what colors we have to use for these ones. Okay, for this guy we use let's see, a brighter shade of orange. Okay, and for this guy we use yellow. For this guy we use a brighter blue, and for this guy we use a purple, and swap back our colors. Yo, and finally we have this shape here, and of course you know how to achieve this, right? We did it in our last video. Just drag it out like this, give it a black stroke, and then Control C, Control F, which is copy and paste in front, and then make it rotated like this while holding down Shift, of course, and select the both of them. Control C, Control F, hold down Shift and rotate like this. Then select all of them again, Control C, Control F, and just adjust them like this. And yeah, we're done with our second design. And looks very perfect. Yeah, so in this video, we were able to work with the Pathfinder tool again, and also we were able to learn about the Shape Builder tool. So that will be it for this video, and see you in the next one.